Les loupes dans le sec, on est fly comme un boudel. Toujours fait partie du tout, voilà tes sons dans la bouteille. Rap intelligent, c'est un moteur.
You're listening to 95.8, the number one station in the city, and I'm Patrick No. Let's get real here, all right? We live in a left-wing dictatorship run by goddamn green fascists who want us to be content drowning in our own white shit. How about clearing the snow from our streets, assholes? And if you don't drive, do us a favor and stay home. Anyway, traffic's gonna be a mess all day today. Speaking of winter, you know those pretentious assholes on Peacock Island who turn their noses up at us? Well, the peacocks on Peacock Island don't like winter. You wanna know why? They can't play golf. So these entitled islanders have more money than God and don't know what to do with it. And they're such massive entitled snobs.
Hey, don't text and ride, kid.
What?
Don't text while you're riding.
I'm not texting, I'm watching a video.
It's red!
Le crâne brillant, demande quelque chose, je le saurai. Mr. Webb, si tu sais
le shit.
Yeah, sure, winter's here, but not for the rich, who just want to golf all year round. That bunch of snobs don't give a damn about anything. Not even nature. Now listen, I've got nothing against the rich. I mean, the really rich, mind you. But these pretenders, spewing their liberal views, piss me right off. Know what I'm saying? They drive me crazy. You can bitch and complain to me all you want, but the world is going to hell, and I've had it.
Do you want some salt on your giraffe? No? It's okay like that? Oh, like that? Hello, André. Hello, Camila. How are you, Camila? Did you have a nice day, Camila? How's Honey? Is she still teething? Hope it's not too painful. Hello, André. No, your mother is not home yet. Honey, say hi to your brother.
All right, Pat, you done, I'll pick you up.
Dad, I told you I'm busy after.
After what?
After work, silly.
Okay, so we're not eating together.
Dad, go out, see other people, do something fun.
Oh, it's okay, I've got something after two.
Yeah, I know what that something is, and it's kind of weird.
And what about you? What are you doing after?
You don't want to know.
Bye, love you.
Bye.
Thank you.
Andre.
Yeah?
Your mom is really late. I've got to go. You look after Annie.
Huh? What? No.
Andre, my family needs me too. They're waiting.
Come on, Camilla, please.
What are you so afraid of? She's not going to eat you. And she's sleeping now. I put a bottle in the fridge in case she wakes up. Okay? I'll see you tomorrow.
This is a scary video, but don't worry. There are no victims here. One of the many laws of the jungle is the need to eat. But if the prey is impossible to reach, the animal soon gives up to conserve energy. Big cats vary between being ferocious and in a vegetative state until the next chance they get to bite into fresh meat.
This should do it.
Shh! Stop it! Shh. You want a bottle? My cell phone, huh? Take it. Annie, go to sleep or the big teddy's gonna eat you.
Oh, boy, Dad.
What? What is it?
Not doing enough for my family.
You can at least tell me his name.
Mohammed Akhtir. He's an imam at a mosque.
Come on.
Okay, his name is Serge Tremblay, a lumberjack who likes to crochet flower vests.
Get serious.
Who cares what his name is? What's important is he's nice to me.
Look, you can come back when you got your papers, okay? This is ridiculous.
What are you doing? She just doesn't have her papers.
Are you intimate?
Yeah, come on, Dad. Seriously?
What? I can ask?
No, you can't ask, no. Dad.
What are you doing?
Updating your contact photo.
Ah.
Ver los que hay detrás!
Let's go get your papers. I'm not gonna let you down.
I said get up! Come on! Camilla's late, and I've gotta go.
Mom, this is crazy.
What is?
You work too much.
Gotta pay for the house, school, the car, sailing lessons.
I hate sailing.
It's important to socialize.
I hate socializing.
I do too, but got no choice. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Golfing in the winter. The rich don't give a shit about the laws of nature.
Look out!
Yeah, Mom, Camilla still isn't here yet. I don't know what to do. Call me. Oh, boy.
Wanna have lunch together?
Bye, Dad.
I'll pick you up after work!
See ya! Thank you. Oh, yes, my love, we're here.
Maud, Marcel, how are you?
Our genius.
Don't mind her. Come on, Ruby.
Quite the guard dog. You must feel very safe with her around.
You're gonna surprise us, I hope.
The course is ready. Your members will get their money's worth.
If they play two rounds a day every day of the year, they still wouldn't get their money's worth. Golf is... it's not a sport or a game. It's a social status.
Oh, come on now, Ruby. Let's go. Oh, good girl. Ah, that's my precious.
Meanwhile, our city is overrun with the poor and immigrants who we have to support because we're good, kind people.
We're doormats. We let them in like it's some frickin' hotel, and we pay for the room.
That's just... it's just common sense. We're living beyond our means. Can't you see that? Hey, guys, real life is no walk in the park, okay? Time to wake up.
You're listening to 95.8, the city's number one station with Patrick Nell.
You almost broke the TV. Ah, shit.
Undo the diaper. Like this.
Huh?
Try folding it up to keep everything in. We don't want anything dropping out. There may be a variety of colors. Normal yellow, green, brown. You may notice a smell. Don't worry. Quickly, put on the clean diaper. Use an adhesive tab to seal it closed. Or, you might be in for a nasty surprise. Give
me a 7-iron.
He said he wants a 7-iron.
Okay. Chill out.
Hey, leave me a message.
Hurry up, okay, honey? Ruby's waiting for us in the clubhouse, and she must be so bored. Golf is so slow, isn't it?
Hey,
you're starting to give me a hard on, you dirty girl. I'll be worth the wait. I'll be there in 5 minutes. Gabe.
Bye-bye.
Amanda? Sweetie? I'm home.
I'm in the bath.
Hold on, I'm coming. Huh? What the?
Jack?
Yeah, I'm coming. Next step is to change the whole damn climate here.
We're working on it.
Thanks. Next time, she's gonna get such a big tip she'll see which side her bread's buttered on. Where is everybody?
Get out of here! They're sick!
Ruby! Ruby! Come see Mama! Oh, who's a good girl? Come here!
Shit, Jesus H. Christ! want to unionize or what?
Nice one, Mom. Seriously?
Give me a break. I'm here, okay? I can't cancel house viewings just like that. Does it bug you that much to miss school?
Not at all.
Then what's the problem?
She's crying.
I know. I can hear her.
Are you the one that called?
Yes. They're always noisy, but this time, it sounds like they're going at it tooth and nail.
Oh, yeah? Go back inside, I'll deal with it. Thank you. Hello? You okay? Badge 122 to dispatch. Hello? Hello?
Hey, leave me a message.
It's me. Something weird's
going on. I've got a bad feeling. I'm gonna go get the truck and pick you up, okay? Call me as soon as you can.
There are people on the street who seem, pretty bad.
Sweet Pea, stop putting everything in your mouth.
It's normal. She's teething.
Oh, look. Who's an expert pediatrician?
Among other things.
Honey, can you prep a bottle for your sister, please?
Oh, Mom, come on. I've taken care of her enough today. Make the bottle yourself.
Oh, you better change that tone, mister, and just do what I ask. No, use bottled water. How many times do I have to tell you?
Babies are pretty tough, you know. They don't need to exercise every day to be healthy. Unlike you, Ma.
I'm eliminating toxins.
Yeah, but it's a drag, because I read that stress increases your level of toxins. Maybe you should be relaxing instead of exercising and taking antidepressants, right?
He thinks he's so smart with his smartphone, huh? Ugh.
Mm-hmm. Coke 1 and kale juice 0. Mom, did you overdose on kale? Mom, eat something! You're hypoglycemic!
Come on, Pat, pick up, pick up!
I'll give you clonazepam, okay? C-Rat, Rivotril, Valium, Ativan, Xanax, a big snake up!
Don't touch her.
Mom? What's wrong with her?
I don't know, but she's not the only one.
Well, call an ambulance.
911 just hangs up in my face. Go home, lock your doors, and stay hidden.
Zombies?
Never seen a zombie with green eyes.
You've seen a zombie before?
Yeah, sure.
Really?
On TV. Boss, we can't enter the island.
10-4, what's the situation over there?
It's a little hard to explain.
Out of my way, lady.
What were you doing outside? It's gonna be okay, Annie. You hungry? Here. You don't want your bottle?
have to bring all of them with you? This is a fucking nightmare.
You ran over my mother.
And you're the one watching videos on your bike.
Whatever. I need to make up a bottle.
Well, there's a lot of food here.
Where's the formula?
I wouldn't know. Look around. Must be here somewhere.
How long have you been here?
Since yesterday.
So what's the plan?
What plan?
Well, we can't just stay here.
We can't cross the river. All the boats have been put in storage. You could always try swimming, but it's a bit cold.
Yeah, well, I need to go get some food for my sister. What are you doing?
It's okay, Pat. Calm down. It's Patricia. She's my daughter.
Your daughter? She's infected.
She'll get better.
M prefers to keep their business practices confidential. Discretion is a corporate necessity, standard operating procedure. Experts are on their way to repair the damage. It is crucial that everyone follows and respects the protocol to ensure the continuation of our activities.
Do what you have to do. Just get me out of here.
We've implemented our own emergency protocol.
The protocol is simple. I just gave it to you.
Stand down. Operation cleanup is underway.
There won't always be gas.
But it helps.
Can't always rely on modern comforts.
Let's be serious for a minute, okay? We know that it's some kind of virus, and we know it's viral. What we don't know is how it's transmitted. Is it in the air, in the water, up in the clouds? Did they all eat tainted caviar, for God's sake? I'm telling you, there's something fishy going on. Anyway,
Let's take some calls. Patrick No is listening.
Yes, hello. I just wanted to say, I think it's another attack by those goddamn eco-terrorists.
What a moron.
They love setting up roadblocks on bridges. Well, now they're blowing them up.
Okay, lose him. Daniel Beauregard.
Ever since they legalized pot, the
yeah,
whole country's gonna
have well, thanks for the call there. We have Daniel Beauregard, the Minister of Public Security, on the line. Mr. Beauregard, who's responsible here?
We're not there yet. We launch an inquiry. We need to find the cause of all this before we start disrupting the status quo.
The status quo is a death sentence, Mr. Beauregard. If you would please just answer the question honestly. This is not the time
I'm
for double talk.
I'm just saying that we need to find the cause.
What are the chances of survival for those infected?
I think it's better to talk about the catastrophe, which is diverted. We've got to look at the positive side.
The positive?
If we know nothing, we do nothing. That's our policy. That's why the people voted us into office. Thank you.
Well, that was Daniel Beauregard, Minister of Public Security. Another incompetent fool. You don't need a diploma to figure this one out. When an arm has gangrene, you cut it off. And now, a message from our sponsors. We'll take more calls after that.
What's wrong?
This radio broadcast is brought to you by Ed, the constellation caring for your...
Hey.
Just a brain freeze.
Helps Mother Nature adapt to your needs. Say goodbye to weeds and buckets. And to those pesky insects.
Is it true what that guy said?
And on your side.
They're ready to sacrifice us to protect themselves?
Live well, live big.
They're scared.
We can make it happen.
They're afraid of us.
But you and I aren't even infected.
Hi, Patrick. I listen to you every day.
You have good taste, sir.
I'm calling from the island. I saw it all. But I'm not infected.
I'm here with three kids, and I'm sure there are others who aren't infected who want to leave. We need your help
What's your name?
Dan. Dan Jango.
Listen to me, Dan, okay? I want to help. But you gotta help me help you.
You say you're not infected, but how can you be sure?
Look, Patrick, I know what it is to be infected. Christ, my daughter's in the fridge and she's green.
I'm sorry about your daughter, Dan. How many of you survivors are there?
There are three of us here, but I'm sure there are others hiding.
And we really need help.
Dan, listen to me, Dan. It's important.
Do you know what's exactly happening on that island?
Because I don't. And that makes me very nervous.
Know what I'm saying?
Nobody's listening to us.
When we call 911, they hang up, for fuck's sakes.
Dan, you gotta understand, we don't want your germs. We've gotta be damn sure of what the hell's going on over there before we send in the army.
We're the victims here. We're not the bad guys.
That's not what you just said. You told me your daughter was green, Dan. What the hell are we gonna do with her?
Dan?
We can't just stay here. We gotta do something. They'll
what?
They'll treat us as if we're infected too.
Come on, Annie. Try it. Mom liked this too.
Here.
Look at you. You're eating, sweet pea.
Patricia also liked yogurt.
Thanks. Well, now what do we do?
We'll take care of ourselves. Me and Pat will hide in the woods. I've been preparing for this for a while. You can join us if you want.
No. We've got to find what's causing this. You want Pat to be cured, right? We've got to find a vaccine. To make a vaccine, we've got to find the cause.
Guess so. It's the water.
Huh?
The only thing that'll infect everyone at the same time.
It's true. I never drink water.
What if it was poisoned by terrorists? Easy to get into a water plant. There's no security.
Huh. Terrorists? On our island?
Well, it makes sense. What's so funny?
I don't know. Terrorists?
Well, it's not funny.
Even Annie thinks it's funny.
Well, it's not.
Why didn't you kill her?
Because she's someone's daughter.
How old is this crate anyways? There's no power socket.
To do what?
I don't know. I could charge my cell.
Here, take mine. Who did you want to call? Do you have family around here?
Nope. No one's left.
Sorry.
Back with another caller. Camila Sanchez, go ahead.
Do you realize what you're doing?
What is it I'm doing?
You're calling for murder.
No, excuse me, but I'm not calling for murder.
Just listen to me. At this moment in time, there's a couple of thousand people who are infected on an island, okay? It's serious, it's sad, it's distressing, but we can still limit the damage.
That is where I'm working, sir. There are nice people there. Before we condemn them all, why not save the ones who aren't ill?
Madam, I find that very noble. Great idea. It's very generous, full of good intentions. But if this thing continues to spread, then millions of people will be in danger.
Yes.
Hundreds of millions, maybe the entire population
of the planet. Is that really what you want? A few thousand people?
Or everyone else in the world? Would you actually choose that couple of thousand on Peacock Island? Come on. By the way, listening to you,
I'm detecting a slight accent. You're not a Quebecer, are you?
You sound like you're a Latin American.
I am a Quebecer.
Yeah, I know. Quebecer, but originally Latino.
Didn't your ancestors perform sacrifices? I'm sure they did.
Pardon?
Human sacrifices.
Like the Mayans. They sacrificed humans to feed their god. And the Aztecs offered a human heart to their god.
Tezcatlipoca to ward off cataclysms. I mean, the Incas sacrificed their children
when the emperor was sick. Children under 8, I'll have you know. So don't come here and lecture us on our morals, okay? Let's hear some music now, why don't we?
Hey, I'm a
She's gone.
Cretino.
Wow, that was awesome. You're great. I love you. You're the best. You're the best. That's what I call radio, my dear.
I guess you're the protocol that they sent. I've burned all the documents, the contracts. You should get rid of the rest of the fertilizer and change the grass back. Do you have the, This will kill the molecule within 24 hours, everywhere. In the water, the grass, and...
Grass. Beautiful green grass.
Oh, the... No!
We can't take the little one. If she cries, we won't be safe.
What about her?
We can't leave her with the baby.
Thank you. smells worse than a dirty diaper. They sure love their water.
Son of a bitch.
I'll just wait here, okay? Each other. Oh, shit.
Run! I'm running! Go on, run!
Don't worry, I am!
That's enough, come on. Hey, come here. Come on, Pat. I'm fed up. I've had it with this shit. Fucking shit. It just broke off. Like a dead branch.
Stay here. Do you know your daughter's password? Dan? Dan? What's wrong? Yes! It worked!
What the fuck are you doing?
Weird. There's grass growing.
Grass. Grass in winter.
Okay, so what does that mean?
It's not terrorists. It's golfers!
Okay, let's go.
Yeah, I'm coming.
Hurry up, let's go!
Yeah.
Hello? Open up! We're not infected!
Except one! Hey, you'll understand.
Watch her. I'll be right back.
Grass that gives off smoke on the net, but I didn't find anything.
Put the damn phone away. This is where it's happening. It's just till we find a cure, Pat. You're too fragile.
I'll be right back. I need to help Dan. What are we looking for?
Something, I don't know, something that makes grass grow in the winter, melts snow, and gives off smoke. Ah, shit.
What's wrong?
I left my flashlight at the water plant. What'd I tell you? Breathing.
It's a dog. Looks like it turned into grass.
We got no time to lose. Pat's not gonna end up like that. Keep her quiet. I'll keep going.
Yeah.
Andre?
Yeah?
Where's the button for the light? Thanks.
Dan? The arm?
Here. Andre?
Yeah?
Be careful.
You too. Annie!
Bastards.
Sweet pea, I was so worried. Never do that again, okay? Who are you? you touch my sister, I'll... I swear I'll... Hello? My name is, André Boisbriand. I'm on Peacock Island, and I'm not infected. The infected are attracted to sunlight and water. It seems like they've been genetically modified so that grass grows on them. This is my sister. She's green. I understand why you've had to quarantine us, but... she's gonna look like this pretty soon. I need some help, please.
The mortality rate for those infected stands at 100%. That's way more than the Ebola virus, Minister. 100%. If you're infected, you're dead. 10,000 infected, 10,000 dead.
Well, I don't think our numbers are the same.
Bullshit. My numbers are bang on, and you know that, Mr. Minister of Public Insecurity. Now, I'm gonna ask you a question, but I'm warning you. It's a hell of an important one.
Go ahead, I'm listening.
What are you going to do to protect the population from an infection that's 100% virulent?
100%.
What we want to do is create...
when a limb has gangrene, the only way to save the patient is amputation.
Amputation?
You take a saw and you cut off what's rotten. Are you ready to take out the saw, Mr. Minister? Are you ready to save Quebec?
Easy now, easy. I'm not infected. It's gonna be okay, Pat.
War is war. We don't live in a fairy tale land of unicorns and rainbows. We're being threatened. We're in danger. The self-righteous assholes put us in danger by welcoming those who would destroy us. You want to protect your way of life, your culture, your world? It's either us or them. All right. The minister says the epidemic has been contained.
André! Hey!
Those idiots finally got it through their heads.
André!
Sometimes you have to point them in the right direction. After the traffic report and an update on sports, we'll hand the mic over to our buddy Richard and his talk show. We're gonna head back home for some well-deserved R&R. You're listening to 95.8, the city's number one station, with Patrick No. Have a good one.
Annie! You are safe, my little angel.
Oh, mi querida.
You okay?
Dame leche, por favor.
People of Quebec, we have just experienced an unprecedented event in our history. And except for the unfortunate inhabitants of Peacock Island, we got through it unscathed. We managed to contain the epidemic, stop the breakout of contamination, and eliminate every last trace of infection. The perfect coordination by the police force, the army, and the private sector makes us all very proud. This protocol will be followed from this day forward here and around the world. Excuse me. Quebecers, I just want to let you know we can now celebrate and sleep easier tonight.